Hello friends, today we are going to solve a problem on crane hook. Okay, as you can see here, this is a diagram of a crane hook of cross section, rectangular cross section. Okay, there will be many types of cross sections in crane, like circular, rectangular, tapered and I section, etc. Okay, so let's start our problem. In this given, the load acting on the crankshaft is 20 kN. Okay, the load acting is 20 kN and it is acting in the center here. Okay, here it is, the load is acting, and the given H is equals to 100 mm. H is nothing but this cross section height, or you can take length, is given H, which is 100 mm given. Okay, so first of all I will draw this diagram here. Okay, and this is the main axis, this axis in this. Okay, so for this rectangle cross section there will be one central axis and one neutral axis. Okay, so from this axis, this starting of this cross section is known as R. Okay, represented by R, and the R internal, and the last one from here to the end is known as R outer. Okay, this is central axis and this is neutral axis. Okay, from here to here it is represented by R N. Okay, and from neutral axis to central axis of this cross section it is represented by R. Okay, this we have to keep in mind. Okay, so for each cross section there will be different formulas for R, N and R. Okay, for rectangle cross section it will be different, for circular, tapered and I section will be different R, N and R values, which we will find in our machine design data book. Okay, so we will continue with our sum. So first of all, what we need to find is stress in inner and outer fiber. Okay, this is the inner fiber and this is the outer fiber. Okay, stress in this both fibers we need to find out. Okay, so first of all we need to find the area of this cross section. Okay, which is breadth into height, we know it is rectangular. Okay, given breadth it is given as 20 mm. Okay, it will give in the question. Okay, 20 mm breadth, and height is given 100. So 20 into 100, which we will get as 2000 mm² area. So now we need to find the RN. For RN from data book we will get this equation formula. Okay, H by log E R naught by RI. Okay, H is given log E R naught and RI. Okay, what we need to find out is RN. Okay, we will substitute this all equations. RN is equals to H is 100 by log E R naught. R naught is what from here to here. Okay, it is nothing but 150 mm. It is given in question, 150 mm R naught by RI also it is given as 50 mm. Okay, now okay, sorry, 150 is above and 50 is here below. Okay, so now if we solve this we will get around 91.07 mm, the RN value. From here to here it is 91.07 mm. Okay, now we need to find distance from here to central axis, which is R. Okay, the formula of R from data book we will get it as RI, which is this, plus H by 2, means this is H by 2, it is correct at center. So H by 2 plus RI. Okay, so RI is given 50 plus 100 by 2, we will get 100 mm, okay? The R value is 100 mm. Now, the distance between the central and neutral axis is represented by E, okay? E is the, see here I will write, E is equals to what? R, this R minus this portion is Rn, R minus Rn, okay? R is 100 minus 91.07, okay? Then E value will get as 8.93 mm, okay? We got E value also. Now we will find the X. X and Y, we know. First we will find the X. X is what? X is nothing but the distance between the load acting and the centroid axis, okay? And it is same, X is same as R, okay? R is also at center. Distance between load acting and central axis is R. So X is also R, okay? So X value is what? 100 mm. Okay, clear? Okay. Now we will find another thing, that is bending moment. Bending moment about central axis we are going to find out. It is represented by M. Bending moment formula is weight into distance is X, okay? Weight is given as 20 kN in question. Okay, 20 into 10 to the power of 3 into X is what? 100. So we will get bending moment around 2 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton mm. Okay. Now, after bending moment, we will find out tensile stress. Okay, at XX axis, it is represented as sigma. Tensile axis, tensile strength, tensile stress. Okay, we are going to find out. Stress formula is load by area. So load, it is 20 into 10 to the power of 3 by area, we got 2000, okay? So by solving it, we will get 10 megapascal, okay? Tensile stress is 10 megapascal we got. So now, we will find the yi and y naught values. Yi and y naught, okay, I will show what is yi. You can see here, till from this starting to the central axis, neutral axis, it is yi, okay? And from neutral axis to this end, it is y naught, okay? This is yi from here to here, and from the neutral axis to this end, it is y naught. We are going to find out this, okay? So first we will find yi. Yi, it is, we can find by Rn minus Ri. If we do, we will get yi, okay? Rn minus Ri. So it will 91.07 minus 50. So it will come around 41.07 mm. Okay, yi is this much. So now we want to find y naught. Y naught we can find by R naught minus Rn. Okay, first I will show for better understand. This is central, this is neutral axis, okay? This is yi, y naught, this is the load acting axis, this is R, internal, this is R naught, this is Rn, and this is R. Okay, for y, what we did? Rn minus Ri, sorry, for yi we did Rn, this minus this. So we got this portion yi. For y naught what we did? R naught, means from total we subtracted Rn. So we will get till here, okay, which is y naught. So y naught value, if we substitute the values, we will get 58.93 mm. Okay, now what we need to find is maximum bending stress inside fiber. Okay, in question it is given to find maximum bending stress in inside fiber. So the formula is bending moment into yi, okay, into area into eccentricity into ri. So we know all these values, just substitute. Bending moment is 2 into 10 to the power of 6 into yi, we got 41.07, and area we got is 2000, and e value we got 8.93 into ri, it is 50. So by solving this in calculator, we'll get 92 newton per mm square. Okay, bending stress in inside fiber is this much. Now for outside fiber we need to find out same formula, but instead of yi we will take y naught. Okay, m into y naught by area into e into r naught. Okay, for internal we will take ri, for external we'll take outer fiber, we'll take r naught. So substitute all this, we'll get a bending stress in outer fiber is 44 megapascal. Okay, so the resultant stress, so resultant stress means total, means y t, the tensile stress, plus y bi, which is the inside fiber stress, resultant stress in inside fiber, it is for inside fiber. By adding this we will get resultant stress. Okay, for resultant stress for outer fiber we will get by sigma stress, tensile stress plus this bending stress of outer fiber. Okay, so this was the sum, hope you understood.